Hello everyone, myself Sakshi Singhwal and I am with Dr. Sudhir Joshi. In today's video, we are going to talk about the new education policy of 2020. As we have seen, everyone is talking about this new education policy from couple of days. What is the new education policy is all about? In this video, we are going to talk about each and every single detail of it. So let's start from where it is started. In 1968, under Indira Gandhi's government, India gets its very first education policy. After that, in 1986, under Rajiv Gandhi's government, India gets its second education policy. Moving on later, in 1992, we did not get the new education policy, but we have seen some modifications in that under Narasimha Rao's government. So my question for you is that what are the main reasons that we have changed our education policy from after the long gap of 34 years?
First of all, I must say on 29th July 2020, a historical day we all witnessed. As we all know, on that very date, our Union Cabinet approved National Education Policy, and last year the draft was submitted to MHRD Minister, and the draft was headed by K. Kasturi Rangan. As we all are knowing, he was a former chief of ISRO, and after getting more than 2 lakh suggestions, our Union Cabinet right now approved it, though it will be our new education policy, or what we can say national education policy, is going to be implemented from next year. And I must say this being a very good effort, or what we can say this being a very commendable job of our government, as our government is going to provide a quality education too, and also our government is in need of skilled, talented and professionals populations too. And for that reasons also, what we can say, after a huge gap of 34 years, we are having a national education policy now, right now.
Okay, my second question for you is, according to you, what are the major reforms in school level of education under this new education policy?
I must say there are very drastic changes are there in our school education system. Earlier when we are studying, at that time we were having a curriculum of 10+2 structure at that time we were following at that time. But right now, from 2021, we are going to witness a new system, and new structure will be there. It will be of 5+3+3+4, just being a formula for all of us. But we can say 5+3+3+4, and the denotation of 5 is of is for what we can say for nursery, LKG, UKG, and in between first and second is also included in that. Up to first, second class will be included under 5. And after that, 3 is denotation is for 3rd, 4th and 5th. And after that, 3, again 3 is there, 6th, 7th and 8th. And last 4 denotion is for 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th. And first of all, I must say, our government and this policy is focusing on our local languages, our home languages, and what we can say our playground languages. Up to class 5th, we can have our education in our local languages, our home languages, our playground languages. So it will be very beneficiary for all the students who are in our country, that is, they will get their education in their familiar languages too. And what we can say, a major step is there, major changes is there in class. After class 6, we will be having some vocational courses also. If somebody wants to do internship, somebody do want to have some, what we can say, coding, decoding in computer, one is interested in automobile, in computer, in gardening, if somebody wants to become a carpenter, if somebody wants to become a painter or architect, for that vocational courses are there. And from 6th onwards, we will be having such type of vocational courses. Bagless study will be there. After what we can say, a huge pressure was there, as we can say, after 10th, what we have to choose, a science stream or arts stream we have to choose. So a lot of pressure was there earlier at that time. But right from this national education policy will be implemented from 2021, all those students after passing their 10th, they can choose any subjects they like. And what we can say, multidisciplinary subjects they will be having their choices. If somebody wants to have chemistry, and in between he also like music, he can take that subject also. He can take a subject of commerce also. So such type of freedom is also there. So this being a very drastic change, what we can say, a report card will not be there. every student will be getting a holistic approach. Progress report card will be there, and the assessment will be not only of the teacher but his friends and himself. They can, and even their parents will also give marks to their what we can say to their child also. So such type of assessments will be there, and what we can say, very drastic changes are there. The structure earlier I was saying of 10+2, right now the new structure will be there. Main focus will be on vocational courses and all the education from a practical, what we can say, from practical knowledge based education system will be there right through the beginning. This education policy is going to be going to focus on our practical knowledge. Unless and until we are not having a practical knowledge, we will not going to survive. What we can say, a theoretical point of view, we can the rote learning, as we were talking about rote learning, so such type of rote learning is abolished in this case, finished in this case, and practical knowledge, this government is going to focus on practical knowledge. So such type of changes are there in case of school education system.
I must say that this is a kind of phenomenal act done by our government, that we witness is such kind of very, you know, it's very important for our children that they must be knowing about the practical thing as well as the theoretical thing hand by hand. So my last question for you is, like, what will be your opinion of national recruitment agencies and how this is beneficial to everyone?
Yes, I must say, before going to the National Recruitment Agency, I must say there are lots of changes in the higher education system also in case of new national education policy. I must say, in case of higher education system, a central thing will be now, all the agencies we were hiring about, UGC, AICT, such type of agencies are now, the things will be of past. And I must say, one governing body will be there, and I must say multidisciplinary subjects will be there. If 4-year undergraduate programs will be there, integrated courses will be there, we will be having an advantage, as 1 year of our PG course will be safe. As if somebody, for example, if I am going to do MA classes, if I want to do MA in for example, I am saying MA political science I have to do, and in BA I have opted that subjects also, and that is an integrated course. So I must say, within 4 years I can complete my MA, and I must say a very, very beneficiary thing in case of this national education policy related to the higher education system, there is a point, we can say multiple exit and multiple entry point is also there. Earlier, but we all are facing such type of problem earlier in this scenario. I must say, if somebody is studying for 1 year and second year, third year, and in between, for some reasons, if he is going, he or she is going to be selected in somewhere else. Okay. So their first year, if somebody is going to be selected in first year, so their first year is ruined at that time.
Yes.
But this government is going to do, if somebody wants to have an exit in first year, so he will be getting a certificate. If somebody is going to exit in second year, he or she will be getting a diploma. After 3 year of completion of his studies or her studies, they will be getting a degree courses. So such type of things are there. Our marks will be in the form of credit. Academic bank will be there. And if somebody wants to again rejoin their studies, they can do. Such type of flexibility is also there. And such type of freedom is also there. And I must say, more than 100 foreign universities, their campuses are also being will be set up in our country, so that there will be a healthy competition in our universities and their universities campuses too. And I must say, 6% of our GDP is going to be invested in case of education system. What we can say, as earlier you were telling about, in 1968 Kothari Commission was set up and first education policy was approved at that time. So I must say, from at that very long time, we are talking about that 6% of GDP must be invested on education system or education sector. But right now, in this new education policy and national education policy, this is going to be focused, that we are going to spend 6% of our GDP. So this being a very, very good step. and what we can say gross enrollment ratio is also there. We must have to increase our gross enrollment ratio from 27% to 50% up to 2030. We have to do such type of thing in case of higher education system, and in case of school education system, right now our GER is 67% and we have to increase it up to 100%, and the target is of 2035. So there are very, very drastic changes are also there. So we must say, in case of national education policy, major changes are there, though their implementations will be from 2021. So we are just going to watch that all the things which has been written over the paper, they must be implemented. And first of all, I must say, as your question was related to National Recruitment Agency, I must say this being a very, very big answer to all the oppositions, what we must say, as they are always, they are asking what this government, this particular Modi government, is doing about employment, they are doing for they are doing something for the unemployment or not. So this being a very good sign, what we can say, earlier there are many vital, major and main questions were also there, as they were resolved, as we must talk about, as there were issue related to teen talaq was there, article 370-35A was there, again what we can say, CAA was, implementation of CAA was there, NRC to be implemented in Assam, and there are many several cases are there, as we are also knowing about Ram Mandir construction was there. So such type of major issues were there, Modi government was targeting. Such type of issues were resolved, though many issues are also there related to population control, related to uniform civil code, though in future they will be resolved in future. But the thing is that about students, about the unemployed youth, about youth, what Modi government is doing. So this being a very major step, National Recruitment Agency has will be set up, and I must say in near future, common eligibility test will be there, and there are three agencies, SSC, RRB and IBPS. Under three agencies are there. For example, I must say, I must cite an example in front of you. If a student from Chamoli is going to fill up a form for SSC examination, meanwhile he is also going to fill up a form for IBPS as well as for RRB. Three forms he have to fill, three times he have to spend his money. After filling his form, then he has to go, or she has to go to their examination centers, and I must say a lot of money is going to be wasted in that. Time wasted, money wasted will be there of that aspirant. And I must say, after the conduction of this CET will be there, only for the tier one it will be, and only one examination will be there. It will save the time as well as money of that aspirants. And after that, what we can say, this government is doing something worth for the students who are going to prepare for some competitive examinations. So I must say, for tier one they are doing a very commendable job, and later on what we can say, in future, near future, might be many reforms will be there. So this being a very good step taken by a Modi government related to NRA, as a common eligibility test will be there. It will save the time as well as the money of the students too, who are preparing for the competitive examination this must be.
Thank you so much. I must say that, you know, how beautifully Dr. Sudhir Joshi have explained each and every detail about national education policy in 2020 in this video. If you like this video, do share, and if possible, do comment like what you like and what else you want to know about this in national education policy. Thank you so much.